So, what's up guys, and welcome to this guide. This is going to be my new guide, which is called Fraud Dragon Guide up to 5 mil an hour. As I recently posted, it used to be 3.5 mil an hour, now it's over 70k each per bone, now it's crashed for like 4k or 3k, I don't know, but for that time, a period of time, let's say like this, was 17.4k, right? And that could grind you up to 5 mil an hour. If the bones don't get up to 5 mil an hour, I mean, well, up to 17.4k, that would mean that can be 5 mil an hour. Even if you put yourself so hard with dry gores, and that's you won't make it. So yeah, in this guide I'm going to tell you what are the basics of doing this guide, and what you should need, and what should be your gear, and so blah 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 on. And I hope you're gonna enjoy the guide. So let's move on. Hello today guys, and welcome. Today I'm gonna present you my Fraud Dragon's guide and pretty much about it. So let's start with abilities. You're gonna need the kick ability, slice ability, smash ability, sever ability, cleave ability, punish, dismember, fury, assault is the best here, overpower, hurricane, and anticipation, for so you decrease the damage you take for 10%. So the other, you know, two slots here are your choice. So for the inventory or the backpack, whatever you say, you should have the Varric teleports. Three Varric teleports are really recommended, and one anti-fire. Now you can use super anti-fire, but the doses will be the same. So I use anti-fire due to that I can make super anti-fires. You're gonna use two doses per fight and one dose of super Zamorak reflex, which I'm gonna explain later, and super resource flask, which you have to be used in combination with super Zamorak reflex. So other fill with food. Now if you're kinda hybrid and you're just gonna tank there, I recommend bringing just few food, and if you have super anti-fire with turmoil and soul split, then take just two sharks or reptiles, whatever you use, you know, just in case if blue orb shows up and you may get hit hardly. So yeah, this is pretty much about back. Now for the next section, this will be about gear you're gonna use. I use really simple gear, and it has really good, I mean it's good, and it's also very cheap, with some rare items that you should get. So you need the Helm of Nightknot. Well, it's recommend, or just bring a good one, or you know, just bearer's one, it doesn't matter actually. A fire cape, or tether cape, or skill cape, royal dehide body, no shield, because just if you're using the rapiers, then bring offhand and the main one. That will be the best option, but if you have a Morgan spare, and if your generic level is only 85 and you don't have 300k tokens, just use the Morgan spare spear. So then use real D high chaps, Bandas boots, Ringo Valve, Ganodermic gloves, just for the best armor and life bonus. And oh, Bandas boots are, you know, I use them because they have damage, you know, bonus damage, but Gano boots doesn't have this. They have a bit higher armor ratings and life bonus, but they don't have any damage bonus, so this is the advantage over the Gano boots. then use Ammo to Fury, Whisper, or Glory. I use Glory because I'm gonna reach the least, and this is the cheapest method that you should use for successful kills and that stuff. So damage you get, you deal is 1.8k. This is the kinda really low, but no, it's your choice. Then you need around 2+k accuracy to kill them. It's really hard. Critical should be around 6 to 5% No, it depends on what weapon you use and that stuff. So type of the weapon should be stabbing. This is the must, because then otherwise you won't kill them successfully. Due to that, they're weak to the stab type of attack. So speed should be on average. Actually, this doesn't matter. If you're using spear, that shouldn't be fastest, of course, but it's on average. Now I'm gonna present you about other YouTubers present this, but the combat of Rush Dragons are 1.60, and it's just a bit different for dragons, but I'll tell you. So you have the hit chance versus melee. So I have 40% to hit, but this is not true, because the players have 40% more than just regular ones. So this hit chance should be a bit higher. I mean players have 40% lower, yes, and the monster has occasionally 40% higher. So yeah, so 80% against with melee, and ranged is the same here for Rush Dragons, and magic is also the same. I think it also has 10% boost, but I don't know. So yeah, like this. So block chance is also doubled, so you have 40% to get hit, but mostly the dragon's attack are really accuracy, and I mean they're really accurate, and they're gonna hit probably all the time. So 100% is here. No, this is just for players, so it's a bit wrong. No, for monster is a bit different. So yeah, ranged is probably the same, and magic is also the same with 10% boost. So yeah, now it's recommended to have 7k plus life points, and you know, as I said, around 1.5k plus rating, armor rating, which will be the best. Now if you have 95 prayer, that you should use soul split and turmoil, and it will just work the best. So moving on to the next one. So today we're gonna talk about Super Zamorak Brew Flasks. Yeah, not many people know it. Yeah, it's kind of secret. So it was released on 5th May 2013, and it boosts your attack, strength, magic, ranged by 2 levels plus 12% of user levels. But there's a warning, so reduce your defense level plus 10% of your HP. So yeah, it kind of sucks, but we have solution for this. So the best tactic is to use Super Zamorak Brew Flask with combination of Super Restore Flask, and yeah, that's the best option, because you're gonna recover your defense stats, and you're gonna boost your combat stats, except defense. So hello today guys, and today I'm going to talk what familiar to familiar, however you say, to bring. So for the first one, we're gonna talk about Spirit Turbird, which requires 52 summoning, and it could hold up to 12 items. Nice. Also, the price, G price is really relatively low, and it's around 340 GP. Yeah, and it can hold up to 150k total value. Wow, it's, in my opinion, the best familiar. So moving to the next one, this is gonna be a bit more expensive and requires 67 summoning, and this one is called War Tortoise, and it could hold up to 18 slots, and G price really high because of the price of the tortoise shells, which are around 13k. That's why the price is 13.5k GP per pouch. So, but the problem is, actually the point is that it can hold up to 900k total value, which is a lot. I think it's 50k per item. That's a lot. So this is the last and probably the best familiar to bring, and requires the highest summoning level. And this is 96 summoning level, and name of it, which you were waiting for, is Pakyak. It can hold up to 30 slots, and G price is 3.6 KGP, something around. But yeah, the problem is, why I always say the problem, I don't know this one, but it can hold up to almost 1 million. This is 960k total value. I know, but this is around 30.2k per item. But it has also the special ability, which allows it to instant bank the item from the, you know, the inventory of that familiar, which is called Pakyak. That's the best thing here. And now moving to the hunt for the Frost Dragon.
Chosen ones, we sacrifice our blood, we kill for honor. We are the holy ones, our armor stained with blood, we kill the dragon. In glory we return, our destination sent, we slay the dragon. No more living in fear, it's time to raise our king. We made it happen. We'll be right back. chosen ones. We sacrifice our blood, we kill for honor. We are the holy ones, our armor stained with blood. We kill the dragon. In glory we return, our destination set. We slay the dragon. No more living in fear, it's time to raise our king. We made it happen.
We are the chosen ones. We are the chosen ones. We sacrifice our blood, we care for honor. We are the holy ones. Our armor's stained in blood. We kill the dragon. In glory we return. Our destination's ready. We slay the dragon. It's time to raise our fear.